Welcome to your bi-weekly love reading from April 1st through the 15th, 2018. Thank you so much for joining me today. For your reading, I'm using the Thelema Tarot deck as my primary tarot deck. At the end of your reading, I'll be pulling a guidance message from the Roman Angels Oracle cards, for Sagittarius Sun, Sagittarius Moon, and Sagittarius Rising. So if that sounds good, let's go ahead and get started with your reading. Hi Sagittarius, welcome to your love reading today. Hope you guys are all doing well. Let's go ahead and get started. Spirit, this reading is for all my Sagittariuses out there who may be watching. Sagittarius Suns, Sagittarius Moons. Ooh, we have the Two of Cups. True love, also soulmate love. Some of you are in love, connecting with your soulmate on the earth plane. There is definitely attraction here. This is, well, right now we have what Mars is in Capricorn, but I'm definitely seeing attraction happening for you, Sagittarius. All right, let's see if that card comes out in your reading. Spirit, what are the love messages and energies for the sign of Sagittarius? For their sun, moon, and rising. Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, and Rising, and also Venus and Sagittarius, and anyone on the Sagittarius cusp. What do they need to know regarding their love lives from April 1st to the 15th, 2018? This is their bi-weekly love reading. One more shuffle here, guys. If you don't want to watch me shuffle, you can just feel free to jump ahead to the reading. You guys are ready for your reading today. Cards are very just coming out fast here. Too fast, too furious, too fast, too furious. Some of y'all are driving. Like to drive fast, like fast car. Nothing wrong with that. At the bottom of the deck, we have the Page of Pentacles in reverse. If you're dealing with an earth sign, this person may be ignoring your messages. It could also be that someone here is feeling very stuck in a rut with regards to their career. This is also the card of the social climber, someone who is a bit of an F-boy, you know what I'm talking about. So they might be blowing you off for a reason, or it could also just be a missed message here. Let's see what's underneath. Four of Cups. Someone here is withdrawn emotionally or is feeling bored in their love life. It's not seeing the... It's because they're stuck in the past here. They're only thinking about this one cup here, which is true love. And so they're not seeing the other, you know, they're not seeing the other offers. They're not seeing the offer here. This is this person, this earth sign. If you're dealing with an earth sign, they could be stuck on someone from their past, or they may just be going through a difficult time. Let's see what's underneath that, because we have the Page of Pentacles reversed, the Four of Cups, the Ten of Swords in reverse. Oh, they may be getting over heartbreak. They're getting over something that has been very painful for them. So let's take a look at your cards. We have Justice, sign of Libra, Karma, balancing of the scales. Challenges, a Six of Pentacles. What has put you here is a Knight of Swords in reverse. Your thoughts and feelings, you have the Magician in reverse. In your recent past, you have the Knight of Wands. And in your near future, you have the Five of Pentacles. You're experiencing some karma right now with Justice. Okay, this is also the card of marriage. Some of you are married, or some of you have legal court agreements, court stuff coming up at this time. This is telling me that you are getting what you deserve. Whatever the situation is, you are getting what you deserve. It is fair. In the universe's eyes, it's fair. You're getting your justice. This is actually a card of victory. It also says that you have emotionally detached yourself to look at a situation objectively. You're weighing these scales. You are, in essence, making this situation fair. Okay, so it will have a just outcome. You may have strong Libra placements in your chart. Okay, or like I said, you could be getting married or doing something with child support, etc. With the court system, I do think that you will win if that's the case. Yeah, your challenge is the Six of Pentacles, which is also interesting because in this card, the hand is coming down and deciding. Look, we have scales in both of these cards. So it is like, this seems to be regarding, I'm getting alimony, but also child support payments. But for some of you, it's about a decision here regarding, you know, who to give attention to, who to give affection to, who is in need. And so you are trying to be fair in this situation. Also, this is also, I'm sorry, we have Libra and we have Earth sign energy, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Someone here is making a decision of who to give their time, energy, and value to, okay? So that it is fair. What has put you here is the Knight of Swords in reverse. So this could be, again, air sign energy, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius. This person either was very impulsive with their words and speech and they rushed into quickly without thinking, or they are actually stopping themselves, stopping their actions, thinking about what they're going to say before they say it. And so they're not rushing in fast. They're actually, it's a controlled situation where I kind of see them sitting on their head here. They also have, this is the card of internet trolls, people who have nothing nice to say, you know, vengeful words. Also backing out of a situation here. So it could be that someone here wants to say something to you that's not very nice, or someone wants to rush in and do something, but they're holding back with words and speech. Because of the Justice card here, it's telling me that the situation is actually out of your hands. Okay, the karma will take place in the spiritual realm anyway, so you don't even have to worry about this. Don't worry about who you're doling affection out to at this time. It's already been corrected. But I do see someone here who's maybe resisting rushing into something because of the fact that, well, it's the other way around. It's because someone has resisted doing something hastily, even though they don't have much nice to say, which has led to a situation here which creates up, which creates balance, which creates fairness, and actually the karma is what I'm seeing as a result of that. In the past, we have the Knight of Wands. This could easily be your energy. Very fiery, very reared up, passionate. I'm seeing someone here who, very action-oriented, playful, really in your element. Also, the Knight of Wands is someone who is adventurous in love. They may have short, quick affairs. They don't really know what they want, so they kind of dabble, and they're kind of a player. They can be a player. I see this as someone who is less mature than a queen or a king. So they're exploring their passions. They're exploring what they like, what they don't like, because they're not sure what that is yet. So there might have been a situation in your past where there was some playing around. There was some playful activity here. It also represents to me positive news. Someone coming in and living in the moment, really. You were just living in the moment. I'm feeling that someone here did not appreciate that, or someone here has words to say to you, but you have removed yourself from the situation. You may even be withholding affection from possibly an air sign or an earth sign. I'm sensing maybe the earth sign here is the one that you're dealing with here. In your thoughts and feelings, you have the Magician in reverse. So this is telling me you're thinking something is no. You're not going to do something here. You may have give off the impression that you can do something, but what I'm seeing is that your intentions aren't there to make something happen. You Because the Magician in reverse uses all of his tools to create his divine gifts, right? And so in reverse, there's something here that could be seductive. You could be acting, I'm not saying you're trying to swindle people, but you're definitely, your intentions are not to do something as opposed to make something happen. So something is a definite no for you at this point. Maybe it was okay in the past, but now you're I feel like you're detaching yourself from something here. You may be thinking about someone who's like this, who's manipulative, a con artist, someone who wants to come out and seduce people at night, and then they go back to their regular lives. That's kind of the feeling that I'm getting. So you're aware of this energy. Going into, because it's coming up in your conscious level here. Going into the near future, you have the Five of Pentacles. Someone feels out in the cold. This could be Earth sign, but I feel like it's interesting because with the Six of Pentacles in the challenge position, I'm reading it in reverse, withholding affection. Someone is withholding affection from you, Sagittarius, or you're withholding affection from someone else, which creates a beggar, someone who is needy, someone who feels like they don't have enough. So it does create an imbalance, which is why I'm saying things were perfectly balanced walking into April, but someone is continuing to withhold something here, which creates an imbalance with the Five. That's the challenge. The challenge here is to come out of the cold, to see that you don't actually... Now, this could be financial challenges as well. Someone could be struggling with money, or someone could need... I'm seeing someone might need support here, might need money, or be asking you for money. In this situation, there's only one person in this card with the church in the background. They could easily go into this church and ask for help, but they decide to beg outside the church. So it's kind of a card of, I wouldn't say willingly being a victim, but certainly a perception of lack is going on here. Okay, so I don't know. I just get that there's some games being played here, especially with the Six of Pentacles in the challenge position. It's kind of like who has the purse strings in the relationship, and they're maybe using that. There's manipulation going on is what I'm seeing, Sagittarius. So we're going to move into your guidance messages for the biweekly. All right, guys, this is the Romance Angels guidance messages portion of the reading. We'll start with Sagittarius sun sign. I got a couple cards fly out, so I'm going to give you all of them. We have flirt, children, deception, and express your love. So flirting is about extending your lighthearted energy to others, being a little flirtatious. For some of you, your love life is being affected by children. We also have deception. Someone is wearing a false self mask in this relationship, either you or the person you're involved with, and the angels want you to stop this. They want this person to take their mask off, stop being deceptive. This could be a situation where there are children involved, and they also have, they want you to express your love. Go ahead and make the romantic gesture. Okay, so it seems like with flirting and express your love, there's really a call to action here with regards to your lighthearted energy. This doesn't necessarily have to be with us. If you're single, this applies to you as well. Some of you have children and that's affecting your love life. And then, like I said, there's something deceptive going on here. So you definitely want to nip that in the bud. I'll leave the cards like this, so you can see them. Okay. And if you are a Sagittarius moon, we have honeymoon. Enjoy the bliss of holiday times together. Some of you will be going off on a trip. It could also just be that you're enjoying the honeymoon period of a relationship. This is like basically telling me that you've got kind of calm times ahead for you. Things look very sweet. Things look really beautiful. You could actually be traveling at this time, doing something with your significant other, like going off on a romantic trip together. Enjoy the bliss. So if you're a Sag rising, we have let your friends help you and let go of control issues. So with let your friends help you, ask for and accept support from others. This could be a situation involving a third party, okay? And you definitely need support, so reach out to your friends. Don't feel like you have to do this all on your own. Accept help and support from others. With let go of control issues, pretty self-explanatory. They want you to allow the situation to unfold naturally, not force it. So, and that also means don't be possessive, don't be jealous. Try not to be possessive and jealous of this person, and or use deceptive tactics to try and get back at them or to try and manipulate the situation. So both of these cards, this could resonate with different Sag risings or even the same Sag rising, depending on your situation. So Sagittarius, it looks like y'all have a lot going on this month. I hope these messages have helped you, and stay tuned for the mid-month readings. I'll be getting those out soon, I hope. Take care of yourselves and see you soon.